Hi, it's Kathianne Lewis, and this is a faith lift. Here's my dog. I brought him to work. It's a bring your dog to work day, I guess, according to Finley. And he's feeling insecure. He is wanting a lot more attention than he usually does, and that's because we've had some changes in the house. We moved some furniture around. We're getting new furniture. He knows something's up. Lots of shift and just the trauma. We need to get some plumbing done, and dogs feel that and respond to that and want extra care. Now, why am I saying this? Well, first of all, you may have an animal, and if you're going through change, if you're going through anxious thoughts, if stuff's up, they're going to feel it and probably need a little more care. But so does our soul. I think that we try to plow through so many things. We try to multitask our way into a better life, a good life, and not pay attention to what our soul needs. The thing I love about animals is they're really pretty willing most of the time to tell us what they need. For a cat, I need to be alone, or I need to be on your lap. For a dog, I need some attention because things are happening and I don't understand. And our soul, if we really listen, if we listen to that deep part of ourselves, we will discover that there's times when we just need to rest, to relax, to do something soothing. Perhaps watch a comedy. Maybe we need to laugh or get outside and walk. But are we really listening to ourselves, or are we plowing through life, not really experiencing it or living it? If we do so, we're missing something. One of the things I said on Sunday, well, the last Sunday I spoke, is that we can get so analytical and we can critique so much and we can analyze so much that instead of our life passing before our eyes, as they say it does before we die, we'll just have our analysis pass before our eyes, or our critique pass before our eyes, because we're not really in the moment. We're not really saying, wow, all these changes are stressful. To just say so is the beginning of letting go, to not plow through. I had a wonderful friend once tell me that a trouble shared is halved. Even if you just share it with yourself, I think it's even more important to share it with a prayer partner or somebody you trust, but to just say to yourself, wow, I'm anxious. I don't know what it's about, but I'm anxious. I think I'm going to sit and breathe and become still for a while. Or wow, I'm sad. And this is more troubling than I thought it would be. And then we give ourselves permission to be sad. It's a way of going through something. And there is no out but through. People talk about spiritual bypasses, and I think we can't bypass anything. I think we just get stuck. If we're not willing to admit what's going on and move through it, we'll just get stuck in avoidance and never get to the other side. So I hope that's helpful to you, because I'm learning from my animals. If you've got an animal, pay attention. They're teaching you something. Bye for now.
Times in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride, that you need to borrow for. No one can fill those of your needs that you won't let show. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, boy. It won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody. Just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If there is a load you have to bear that you can't carry, I'm right up the road, I'll share your load. If you just call me, you just call me when you need a friend.